Class D chopper. This is the basic circuit of class D chopper. So now in this class D type choppers, in which the power can flow either. That means your power can be flow from load to source or source to load. So now this operation of this chopper is confined in first quadrant and fourth quadrant. Now this class D type chopper is also known as a two quadrant type B chopper. So now it is necessary condition for this chopper is that the load should be inductive. So now it is most important. Now when the chopper CH1 and CH2 both are on simultaneously, so now the input voltage Vs is appear across this load. That means your output voltage V0 is equal to Vs, and this is your positive terminal and negative terminal. Now due to this voltage, current is start from source to load, and it follow the path from plus Vs to CH1 to inductor L to load, and then minus Vs. So you can say that the current is flow from left to right in the load. So now it is taken as a positive. So in this case, your output voltage V0 is positive, and the load current I0, it is also positive. That means this chopper is operates in first quadrant. So it is most important. Now when current passing through this inductor, some energy stored in the inductor. So now current entering to the inductor, L terminal becomes positive, and current leaving terminal becomes negative. And another thing, it is most important, it should be noted that the diode D1 and D2 both are reverse bias. So it can treated as a open circuit, because already we have studied when diode anode is positive and cathode is negative, then it will turn on. So here the diode D2 cathode is positive, anode is negative, that means it will not conduct. For similarly diode D1, so it is most important. Now when chopper CH1 and CH2 are turned off simultaneously, the current does not reduce instantaneously, because due to the inductive loads available as a load. So now, however, it decay gradually, a very high amount of reverse voltage induced across this inductor. That means this positive right terminal becomes positive and left terminal becomes negative. Now due to this reverse voltage, diode D1 and D2 will turn on and start to conducting, and against this load is connected to the source. Now in that time the current is start to flow from positive L to load, then D2, then plus Vs, minus Vs, Dn, D1, and the negative terminal of the inductor. So here you can see that the current pass all in this case, the current is also passing from left to right, and it is similarly to the when CH1 and CH2 on. So but the here another thing, your left terminal becomes positive and right terminal becomes positive and left terminal becomes negative of the output voltage. So in this operation, your output voltage V0 is negative, and the current load current is positive. That means this configuration is operated in the fourth quadrant. So it is most important. Now we will study about the waveform, because we have seen your output voltage may be positive or negative. Now it may be positive or negative, it depends on the value of the period of the T on and T off. So there are two possibilities: either T on is greater than T off, or T off is greater than T on. So first we will see T on is greater than T off. So now when your both are CH1 and CH are turned on, that means current exponentially rise from I minimum to I maximum, and the load voltage appear across the load, and it is in positive condition. But when your both thyristors are turned off and diode D1 and D2 conducting, that time current will exponentially decrease from I maximum to I minimum, and that time reverse voltage appear across this load. But here you can see in the waveform, the during the when T on is greater than T off, more positive voltage appear across the load in compared to when negative voltage appear across the load. That means this positive portion is greater than negative portion, so the output voltage is positive. But now when your T off is greater than T on, then when your thyristor is T on, your current load current is will exponentially increase from I minimum to I maximum, and the positive voltage appear across the load. But when both are off, that means that time your current will exponentially decrease from I maximum to I minimum, and reverse voltage appear across the load. So you can see that the negative portion of output voltage is greater than positive portion. So the net or average output voltage is negative. So you can say that by changing the value of T on period and T off period, your output voltage may vary from positive value to negative value.